this has really been a landmark study across this international consortium trying to understand the genetic basis of depression, and it's really acting as the springboard for many different studies looking at different avenues and asking different questions around what we know about depression. So major depression is commonly referred to as depression, and it's a very common but serious mental health condition that affects 1 in 5 Australians at some point in their lifetime, and this is projected to increase readily over the next 10 years. The aim of this study was really to get into what is that genetic component and see if we can start to identify which genes are playing a role in increasing someone's risk to having depression. For this particular study, it's the world's largest study looking at the genetics of depression. We pooled data from 29 countries across the world, so we ended up with a final sample of about 680,000 people that had had depression, and then we compared this to a sample of 4 million people that hadn't had depression. This is the first study that started looking at depression not only in people of European ancestry, but across other populations across the world. One of the most exciting things around this study is the number of genetic variants. So we found 697, which is a substantial increase on anything we've known before. Also, if we were able to repurpose drugs that already exist to treat other disorders like sleepfulness or narcolepsy, that's really exciting because those drugs are already available. These findings mean we've made a real big leap forward in what we understand about the causes of depression and starting to move towards a more personalized treatment at the right time. Importantly, it shows that there is a strong biological basis to having depression, and that it's time we start moving away from kind of a stigmatized society where this is not something we talk about or we take as seriously as other medical conditions. I feel very privileged to have been part of such a big study, particularly from Australia. So I'm really proud of the mark that we've been able to make in shifting the needle on what we know about depression genetics.